Saw a musical before I was in one. After I'd been dancing professionally for a couple of years, that's when I decided to really become a dancer. Well, I studied with Anthony Tudor when I danced at the Met. He gave a two-hour class from 10 to 12 every morning, and then we rehearsed all day, and then we did the opera at night, and for all of that, we got $80 a week. Flossie said, a dancer who's not an actor is just so much animated wallpaper. You did a little movement with your hip or something. But see, you're not just doing that. You are thinking, look at this. And all of a sudden, the whole face changes. There's something going on in your head. Otherwise, it's just like a can of worms. Watching, you know, people moving around doesn't mean anything. It's got to be you're expressing the music, you're expressing the feeling of the story. And when you see a number that Fosse did compared to a number that somebody else did, the Fosse number jumps off the stage because he had everybody thinking something on every single step. You were very busy when you were in a Fosse show. You worked and it was very satisfying. You were very proud to be a Fosse dancer and to be in that show. Even just in the chorus. When the day that Fosse died, which was the opening night of Sweet Charity in Washington, D.C., he sat down with the dancers after the very last rehearsal about how you can't compete with anybody else. You just have to compete with your own best self. You're not competing with anybody else. And he told people to really save their money. Don't just fritter it away. And I mean, he was talking to this company like a Dutch uncle. And I think somewhere he must have known. He walked out of that rehearsal and died on the street. The thing that's so wonderful about Luigi is that he really dances to the music. And so many people just do calisthenics to the music, and it doesn't have any feeling of what the music is trying to express. If you marry somebody at 20 and you're still married to them when you're 70, it doesn't say much for your growth. I wanted a different kind of man every 10 years. Completely different kind of man. We do change. At first I was definitely had to have somebody in show business, and then I had to have somebody that was my Howard was a psychologist. I thought, boy, that'll straighten me out. Then I thought, no, I have to marry somebody with money. And so I married a businessman the third time. None of it worked, darling. My one and only child.
Your one and only, right? Yeah.
I had a career from the time I was 17 till I was 31, and then I had her. It changes everything, but it's definitely worth it. You're really a choice how you want to feel about people. In any instant of the moment of now, you have like a vertical line, and there's this choice, this choice, this choice, this choice. And whatever you're feeling to people that are around you, they can sense it. If you're being very loving and hopeful, and then that's going to mirror back. And if you're in a show, don't ever mark. Don't mark. Because if you're the one that's dancing full out every time, they'll notice you.
One moment, please. An 88-year-old man needs a little more time than most of us to get started in the morning. Good morning, Mr. Pinchley. He's coming around. That's it, Mr. Pinchley. Come on. Come on, get those lips moving. That's it. You're almost up.
Cinemica, good morning. I got it.
He's all right now. He has another 2 hours before he goes under again. I'll be back at 12. Goodbye, Mr. Pinchley.
Mother.
Irby Fitz is benign, and I'm in rather a and my size to be shy, I'm fickle. Ipswich England's me out, I married something called Emma. One night I chanced to roam, and roamed into a dilemma.
Quite enough. Let's go.
A ball?
Yeah.
Oh, that would be fun.
That would not be fun.
The 80th Annual Academy Awards on ABC.
It's not enough to take the one you love for granted. You must remind her or she'll be inclined to say, how do I know if you love me? How do I know if he's mine? Well, Dad, he'll leave a little note to tell you you are on his mind. Send you yellow flowers when the sky is gray. Hey, he'll find a new way to show you a little bit every day. That's how you know he's your love.
You got to show what you need. Don't treat her like a mind reader. Each day to something to lead her to.
We are bright and early.
We have breakfast dates.
Ooh, you two are quite a pair.
Well, who's the looker?
You don't want any part of him, Reba. He will love you and leave you.
That's the way I like him. After the loving, what are they good for anyway? How do you do, doctor?
Fine, and you?
She gives every Tom, Dick, and Harry the big eye.
Nah, Henry, she's got a thing for you.
Say, where do you keep the toothpaste?
Way to go, Hank.
Hello.
Reba.
Henry?
Hi, guys.
Where's Mo?
We don't know.
Come on, guys, we just want to help.
Please, Henry, can you tell us where he is?
I'm not sure. But, he packed a bag.
Yes, sir, that's my baby now.
By the way,
I will not sing.
By the way,
he believes me.
Yes, sir, that's my baby.
No, sir, don't be
maybe. Yes, sir, that's my baby now.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11.
I was
old once. 2, 3,
when you come
on, back, side, front, look,
side, shout,
front,
look,
back,
side,
front,
look,
front,
look,
front,
look, front, look, front, look, front, look, front, look, front, look, front, look,
front, look, front, look, front, look, front, look,
front, look, front, look, front, look, front, look, front, look, front, look, front, look, front,
cause I've got a friend at last.
The other night, I was watching television, and there was Snoopy dancing around in this commercial, and Lucy came up to him and said, "What are you doing, Snoopy? Are you going to just dance your life away?" And I thought, oh, God, they're talking to me. But then I thought, now, wait a minute. What better way is there to spend the rest of your life than singing and dancing? Come on, babe, why don't we paint the town? And all that jazz, I'm gonna rouge my knees and roll my stockings down. And all that jazz, stop the car, and know a whoopee spot where the gin is.
but the piano's hot. Just a noisy hall where there's a nightly brawl. And all of that jazz. You know why my garter's white? Because everyone that's passed above it's gone to heaven.
But of all the musicals I've ever done, my favorites are still the Bob Fosse shows. No matter what life threw at him, he always found some new way to start over again. So when I panic and feel each day I've come to the end of the line, then I say that fear hasn't licked me yet. And I say to myself, I got steam heat, I got steam heat, I got steam heat, but I need your love to keep away the cold. I got steam heat, I got steam heat, I got steam heat, but I can't get warm without your hand to hold. So when I'm jittery and my knees buckle and ice water tickles my spine, I just give 'em the old razzle-dazzle, razzle-dazzle-em. Give 'em an act with lots of flash in it and hope the reaction will be passionate. Give 'em the old hocus pocus, bead and feather 'em. How can they see with sequins in their eyes? What if your hinges all are rusting? What if in fact you're just disgusting? Razzle dazzle 'em and they'll never get wise. Back since the days of old Methuselah, everyone loves the Pika Bamboozler. Give 'em the old three-ring circus, stun and stagger 'em. When you're in trouble, go into your dad. Though you are stiffer than a girder, they'll let you get away with murder.
Thank you. she is a Broadway treasure, and again, one of the first people that I met when I came here is Marge Beddow.
Bravo!
Well, thank you very much. I had absolutely no idea that I was going to have to say something here. But I tell you, I've been in business now 70 years. No, no, 60 years. Today. It's been a joy and an honor to be in dance and theater all my life, since I was 17. And today I'm 78. Thank you, everybody.
Says goodnight. It's early in the morning. Manhattan babies don't sleep tight until the dawn. Good night, baby. Good night. Milkman's on his way. Sleep tight. Come on along and listen to the lullaby of Broadway, the hidey-high and boop-a-doo, the lullaby of Broadway. The band begins to go to town, and everyone goes crazy. You rock by your baby round, till everything gets hazy. Hush, I'll buy you this and that, you hear daddy saying. And baby goes home to her flat to sleep all day. Good night.